Hi everyone, Basement Creations here.
In my last video, I briefly mentioned that in the future, I want to make a Mavic-like drone using new FPV stuff that just hit the shelves. And I guess some of the brands actually watch my videos, because I just received this box from Kadax and it's full of their brand new Walksnail stuff. So let's take a look inside. Oh, and if you are wondering why was I riding behind the Mars rover at the beginning, well, stick out to the end of the video. Alright, the first thing in the box is the new Walksnail Moonlight kit. Originally Kadax wanted me to test their also new 2W GT unit, but I specifically asked for this particular set, because for one it can record 4K 60 frames, and additionally it can be paired with this fun thing, the Kadax GM3 gimbal. You see, I've been always wondering why no one makes those tiny drone gimbals available for hobbyists, and finally someone did. And what's even better, this gimbal can supposedly link to their also new FPV goggles and do the head tracking all by itself. Kadax was kind enough to send me this Avatar HD Goggles L as well, so we are going to test it all in one video. And they also sent me a cap, because I like caps. Anyway, let's get to work. I started with opening the goggles. First impressions, they are surprisingly small for a single screen box goggles. And they're also really light, but they don't feel cheap. The plastic is actually quite nice. Which is surprising, because I think they're currently the cheapest digital FPV goggles on the market. And you know, it's a breath of fresh air, because since the beginning of digital FPV era, the price of the goggles always prevented me, and I guess many others as well, from ditching the old analog FPV systems. In the box we also get a nice carry bag and the power cable. You can power these goggles by any LiPo or Leon battery packs you have, ranging from 2S and ending at max 6S. Once we plug the battery in, the goggles turn on and we can hear the cooling fan spinning up. The screen in this is full HD 60 frames, and by the first look it seems really nice and sharp. I can also add that you can record the video on the onboard SD card here, but the slot is placed in a rather weird place, since you need to remove the foam pad to get access to it. But to record anything, first you gotta have a camera. And that's where the new Moonlight kit comes in. In the box we got two antenna VTX unit, the camera with ND filter and some connection wires. Everything feels very solid, especially the VTX with its metal radiator case. But because of that it's also quite heavy, the whole kit weighs almost 47 grams. Now to start using this system, I soldered an XT30 connector to the included wire and plugged in a 2S battery, but if you want you can go as high as 6S. And while on the bench, make sure you have a strong airflow around your VTX, since it generates a lot of heat, and I mean really a lot, especially while recording 4K. But anyway, to pair the Moonlight with Goggles L, you simply have to turn them on and press the pairing button on both devices. Then after a while, they connect by themselves and you get to enjoy the full HD live video from the camera. The thing that I really like about Kadax and their Walksnail products is that they still support old hardware. I just tried it and my first generation Avatar kit works like a charm with Goggles L. And also the Moonlight kit works just fine with my old VRX. You just need to update the firmware to the newest version. So really big plus for backwards compatibility. There are also many settings in the goggles menu that you can play with, like the transmit power or the video quality. But the thing that interests me the most is the new head tracking tab. And to get a use out of it, we have to open the third box, the Kadax GM series gimbal. You can actually get this thing in 3 different versions that stabilize in 1, 2 or 3 axes. This GM3 model can move the camera in pitch, roll and yaw, which means we get the best stabilization and head tracking without any limitations. The build quality here is again really good, and it's also surprisingly light, at just 44 grams. The gimbal also comes with a rubber anti-vibration mount and some connection wires. And speaking about connections, there are a few ways you can do it. You can of course use standard PWM to control each axis individually. But the simplest solution is to connect the gimbal to the VTX using 2-wire serial communication. Then I soldered all the power wires to a single battery connector and also added a 40mm fan for cooling. Next step was to attach the coaxial video cables, and for that you have to unscrew the back of the camera, remove the original cable, connect it to the gimbal cable instead, and screw it in the gimbal mount. Then you also have to remove the metal plate covering the cable on the VTX and connect the unit to the gimbal as well. So now, when we have power, data and video connection sorted out, we can plug the battery in and see what happens. On its own, the gimbal just does this slight follow stabilization, but the magic happens when we turn the head tracking on and go into the PTZ mode. And now, as you can see, the gimbal precisely follows the movement of the goggles in all three axes. This is honestly really, really cool. It kinda feels like you are in the VR while wearing it. Truly amazing. But what's not amazing is this whole wire mess. So, to tidy it up, I quickly jumped to Fusion 360 and made this design. It has mounting places for the VTX, antennas, gimbal and also the fan, so that we can combine everything into a single unit. To print it on my new Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, I needed a strong filament that wouldn't become soft from the VTX heat. That's why I used the Titan X filament that was sent to me by the Forum Futura. Thanks a lot! The link to their website will be there in the description. Next, I added a few threaded inserts, zip-tied the antennas, and then screwed everything else in place. Initially, I didn't really know if I would test this gimbal on a drone, or a car, or a Mars rover, so I also designed this protective cage, which hopefully could prevent the gimbal from getting damaged in a crash. And of course, all the files for this mount will be available on my Thingiverse and printables. The fully assembled unit weighs around 140 grams, which is still lighter than many action cameras. And I, for one, don't know any camera that could do this. Alright, but what about the video quality? And to find out, we have to do some field testing. But before that, quick story time. You see, for about a year now, I have been a member of the Raptors team. In my last video, I mentioned the drone competition we went to. Now, let me tell you about the Mars rover competition we just came back from. Every year in September, there is this huge event in Poland called European Rover Challenge, where the best teams from all around the globe put their robotic skills to the test. This year, my team got ambitious, and we decided to build a whole new rover with BLDC motors, 3D printed tires, and a whole lot of improvements from our old design. Unfortunately though, we ran short of time, and not everything was fully tested before the competition. And so, on site, we had some problems with robotic arm, communication and cameras. This last thing was especially important, because just like with the real Martian rovers, all the teams were closed in special tents and no one was able to look outside. The cameras were all we had. And that's why when this Voxnail package came in, I said, hey guys, I have an idea. And so we mounted this whole unit upside down on our communication mast and took the whole rover for a spin around the campus.
So, as you can see, we mounted the Voxnail camera on our Mars rover and we are currently trying to control it only by this camera, and this actually works. A do tego nogi bolą. Ja. Teraz mi uda odpadną. Now Jakub's going to attempt to drive up the stairs. Will he succeed? Seems like he crashed. But our rover has a crab mode, which lets it drive sideways. And now he is going backwards with the gimbal facing also backwards. And he did it! Congratulations!
Not yet. Not yet. Try.
So that was a lot of fun. The Kadax gimbal definitely works great on our rover. It allows the pilot to have a sharp and detailed vision in every direction, and is much more reliable than the multiple Raspberry Pi cameras we used before. If the competition rules allow it, we will definitely use this Voxnail setup to traverse the Mars yard next year. And overall, to summarize this review, I just wanna say that the gimbal with goggles L is really amazing, the head tracking rules, and the 4K footage that the Moonlight Kit delivers is on a level of a good action camera. Really impressive for such a small package. The range is also not bad. Here we mounted it on one of our drones and flew a mission at 1 km distance. The video feed was very stable with some minor noise only when the goggles were facing the opposite direction. I guess the only thing I can complain about is the overheating of the Moonlight VTX. But as long as you are not planning to mount it on an actual snail, even a little movement helps to cool it down. And that's why I'm planning to use this Voxnail gear on all my future projects, which you can take a look at my Patreon site. But for now, that's all for this video. Thanks Kadax for sending me all this stuff, big thank you to my Raptors teammates for helping with this review, and also thanks you guys for watching. We've recently passed 10,000 subscribers, for which I'm incredibly grateful. Some of you even decided to support me on Patreon, and for that, from the bottom of my heart, thank you again. You make my projects possible. Anyway, see you all in the next video, and bye!